Thank you. A few months ago, I received an invitation from René to come to NOMA, to MAD, sorry. And I said, that's fantastic. I'll have four days holidays in Denmark. Absolutely brilliant. But next was, you know, you got to cook at the same time. So I said, what can I cook? You know, I'm not in the same style as you. He said, why don't you do an omelette? I said, okay, an omelette is fine with me, but don't ask me to put any worms or ants with it, because it's not my type of cooking. I cannot do that. I can put some truffles if you want. He said, that's too much expensive. We cannot work with that. So he said, just stick to the simple omelette. So that's what I'm going to do. So to do an omelette, I think everybody knows how to make an omelette. It's just eggs, and that's it, you know. But you can add anything you like an omelette, and it works, you know. It's something you eat at home. Mainly, most of the restaurants, they don't do omelette anymore, maybe because it's too simple. So today we do the most simple omelette. The thing is, you don't make any omelette without breaking any eggs. So a good portion is 3 eggs each. That's what we had. The most important when you do food, omelette or any type of food, is the seasoning. Because I always say to my chef, you know, the difference between good food and bad food is always a pinch of salt. So you break your eggs, you beat your egg to incorporate some air inside. Some people will put a drop of milk, a drop of creams, anything you like you put. I try to adjust that machine. I suppose it will take a few minutes before the butter is ready, yeah. I suppose omelette is one of the oldest food you eat. You got eggs, omelette is all the same. And if you look on all cookery books, you can find hundreds of different omelettes from bacon, potatoes, anything you like. Yeah. So we use only butter. We never use oil. Oil is a bit more indigest than butter. And as a Frenchman, butter is perfect, I got to tell you. So you make sure it doesn't burn. That's the only thing you make sure. So as soon as bubbling like that, you drop your eggs in a pan, turn it non-stop, bring the side back in the middle, I always find it difficult to talk and work at the same time, so I'm not that good at it. But I hope just with the camera is perfect. So I love my omelette when they are a bit runny inside. In France, we said baveuse. Some people like it hard in the middle, but not us. We put a bit more butter. I suppose the Danish people, you got Danish butter, you are famous for your butter and your pigs. Yeah. So the pan is sticking a little bit, so I can blame the pan if it's not perfect. So you make it come back on each side there, fold the side, the ends, both ends, back in the middle. And an omelette should have a little bit of color to be appetizing. If it's too bland, too no color at all, it's not so appetizing. So you make sure, you know, you give just a little bit of color. I think with that fire, maybe it will take a long time, and David back, they won't be so pleased if I spend too much time here. But that's it, roughly. Thank you.